And joining me in studio are Labor Party MPs Opito Williams-Seal, Jenny Salisa, and Dr. Anae Neru Leavasa. While coming to us via Zoom from Palmerston North is another newly minted Labor electorate MP, Cook Islander Tangi Utikere. Tangi, congratulations, brother. How are you feeling waking up this morning knowing that you are going to become an MP?
Oh, kia ora ana, thank you. Can I just acknowledge my new parliamentary colleagues for me anyway? Great to see that Opito, Jenny and Dr. Neru are with you. Look, I'm really excited. We had a wonderful evening. It's still an early start today, but not as early as some I'm told. And yeah, we're just really looking forward to the next 3 years and what our government can offer this community here in Palmerston North.
Break down for us what happened last night. Where were you? What was the mood like? Did you stay up late to watch the polls right till the end? When did you know you'd clinched the seat?
It was our gathering was at the Takaro Sports Club, which is pretty special to me because it's where I started my involvement in local government representing the Takaro community 10 years ago. And so we were watching the results come in. We were refreshing our phones and likewise pretty frequently and regularly. Everyone was so excited. And then as the evening progressed, the other candidates turned up to congratulate me. I had an opportunity to congratulate Piano as well. So for Palmerston North, effectively, there will be, I refer to it as the cookie quinella on their way to the House of Representatives.
I mean, we'll talk about this with the rest of the Pacific MPs here, but were you surprised by last night's result? I know in your seat it's a safe Labor seat, but Ōtaki, which is not too far from you, traditionally a blue seat. Tim Crossy was running there for the National Party. That's gone to Terisa Ngobi. Have I said that correctly?
Ngobi,
Who is of Samoan descent.
So it's Scottish Samoan. Married to an African.
Married to an African. Diversity in spades. Yeah. I mean, were you surprised at all by that? Those results last night in terms of those electorate seats turning red, which were traditionally blue?
Look, I'm excited that Terisa is going to be the local member just south of here. But I think actually we took nothing for granted. So you refer to this as a safe Labor seat. We're delighted with the result at the end of the night here locally. But I think what it does demonstrate is that we had the leadership in Labor. We went to our communities with a plan, and the community has overwhelmingly backed that plan. It's proven essentially that we can deliver on what we have done, and that's just the delight in terms of being able to represent the people that want us to get on and do the job.
Oh, Peter, I want to bring it back to you. By my count here, we've got Labor are going to have 10 Pacific MPs, 8 electorate and 2 list. That's pretty good numbers for the Pacific caucus. Can you run us through some of the people that are coming on board that the public might not know about? I mean, who are these people coming on board?
Well, I mean, you've got 4 new faces, 4 Pacific MPs. Barbara Edmonds is the new MP for Mana. Barbara is not new to us in the political sense, but she's a lawyer, tax specialist. Her husband is of Māori heritage, 8 children, and well embedded in the Mana community. Terisa Ngobi is known to the Wellington region from the public sector, and as I said, father is of Scottish heritage, mother is of Samoan heritage, and married to an African, lovely African man, Ngobi, and they've got a mixed heritage family. Anae, Dr. Neru from Takanini, is known in South Auckland. He's part of our team in Māngere.
And on that, Dr. Anae, tell us a little bit about yourself, because we've got you here. Let's hear it straight from the horse's mouth. Yeah. I mean, again, congratulations, Takanini, a new seat. Yeah. Very mixed seat out there, isn't it? You've got you know, the Takanini electorate, you've got a bit of Hanua and a bit of south of that Manukau. I mean, what was that like for you, winning, and what are your plans for that electorate?
We were really excited last night and really happy with the results. Look, when we came into this on paper, the polling booth, the data from last time showed that it was a lean towards National, about a 3,000 majority. But we knew we could win this seat. So my team and supporters, we did really well in the campaign and really excited about the results. So my plans for Takanini is to first, you know, deal with the issues locally and really get to know the people and the businesses and the community organisations. So, and learn from my senior colleagues colleagues. You know, I'm new to this political sphere, so looking forward to it.
Tell us about the groundwork that you'd laid out there. I mean, what kind of campaign was it? We hear a lot of the Labour electorate candidates were out on the ground, door knocking. Ginny Johnpulu was telling me you're out with a loudspeaker in Otahuhu.
Yes.
So, you know, what was the campaign like for you out in Takanini? Was it very similar?
Yeah, very similar. A lot of door knocks, a lot of phone banking. Because it's a diverse population, a lot of our Indian community, there was a lot of focus there as well, going to Sikh temples, churches, different community groups. So really targeted, but really well-run campaign. Yeah.
Is there anyone else we should keep an eye out, do you think, Aupito, coming through?
Oh, look, you've got Limonga, Lydia Sorsini, who's the chair of the Orohu Mangere local board, and she'll be on the cusp. I remain optimistic. You've got special votes to be counted. You've got overseas votes to be counted. And then you've got the votes that went to the smaller parties that will have to be redistributed. So, you know, I think Limonga will be waiting nervously for the next 3 weeks. But irrespective of what happens to her, we've shown with the 13 that we put up, and particularly the newbies, that there's talent coming through in the Pacific caucus. And so we'll continue to build on that. Mm. I mean, you know, I've tried to describe the diversity of the makeup of the families, because that's what we're seeing with the Pacific community. I've dubbed them the Generation 6Bs. You know, people who are proudly brown, beautiful, brainy, bilingual, bicultural, and bold. And that's what's happening. That's the makeup of the new group of Pacific peoples coming. And I see that as we travel the country.
Ginny, for you, it's a bit of a whirlwind ride for you, because when you started campaigning and you got into to Parliament, and now when you started, there was MPs at this Pacific MPs at this level, and it's growing steadily, and you're riding that wave. What's it like for you seeing them come through?
It really is an exciting time, not only for us Pacific, but actually just when we see, and I've got to acknowledge our Prime Minister, the Right Honourable Jacinda Ardern, for her leadership. This has been a campaign where we focus on COVID-19, very different this campaign to the first two that I ran. And of course, especially here in Auckland, where we couldn't actually go out door knocking, doing the street corner meetings and all that until the very end of our campaign. And for me, my electorate was one of the ones that was really changed a lot. So it used to only end in part of Otahuhu. Now I've taken all of Otahuhu, all of Pāmua, where I live, most of Point England, and a few streets in Gleninus. And so when I look at the overall Pāmua Otahuhu electorate now, I think I actually cover the places where the most majority of Tongans actually live. And so it's exciting for me as a Tongan born candidate to then win the seat. And you know, I think even more Tongans will come asking for support even before I became representing Pāmua Otahuhu. Tongans came to me from all over the country. I think even more so now.
They've got the right colours, don't they, you know?
They actually reach out.
Hey, but quickly before I go, we don't have long, but I want to know, you're in now. Nail some things you guys want to tackle in this 3 years from a Pacific point of view. What can they expect? I'm not going to hold you to it in terms of promises, election promises, because you need to have a discussion about that. But we always mention housing, education. That. What do you guys want to see change in the next 3 years?
Let me begin with education. So one of the things that our Labor Party is already committed to is that we'll implement the Pacific Education Plan. You would see in the budget of 2019, added to the budget of now, 2020, just over $107 million that the government has said we would actually invest in Pacific education initiatives.
This is
historical. We've never actually had this much money actually committed to addressing Pacific educational initiatives.
15 seconds, Alpito, what would you do? So we've got education from Jenny, investing in Pacific education. 15 seconds.
The one area where I really want to accelerate our efforts, and which we've started, is STEM. Our Pacific young people to own the digital space.
So science, technology, education, and math? Yep, for those of you who don't know, STEM.
Oh, yeah, STEM. Okay. But we're also working to generate more Pacific home ownership, and so we want our people to start looking at owning their own home.
Right, get out of that cycle of poverty. Dr. Neru, I already know, Takanini, right? You make sure you hold that and do your best there. But hey, look, stay with us. After the break, we find out what Pacific voters want from the new government, and we wrap up our post-election special with our panel of commentators.